Good. So is Karina on? It looked like Karina was on this call.
Yes.
Or no?
Yep, I'm on. I'm on.
She was. I didn't see her face. She said she was like right after us.
Yeah.
Jesse's on.
But then said somebody left.
Can you hear me?
This is embarrassing. These are all empty boxes.
Now we can see your house, Cindy.
Larry.
Well, David, I'm so excited you can come to Moldova with us.
Yeah.
It will be nice to have another man on the team.
Yes.
I'm sorry that the circumstances occurred for you to be able to do that, though.
Yeah. It's going to be an adventure. Okay, I guess.
But in God's sovereignty, everything happens for a reason to us who belong to Him. Everything.
Something we all remind us of.
That's true.
God has a special plan, David. You know that, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm trying to continue to remind myself that. But I know it.
Yeah. Great.
Okay. Jesse Marcus is on, I think, but I don't hear him anywhere. He may just be listening. Sure. Are you there?
Can Jesse? You hear me at all?
Yes, we can hear you.
Hi, Jesse.
Hi.
All the way from Alaska.
How's it going?
Good.
Wow, isn't that something?
Yep. That is something. Okay. Well, this is. Let's get started and welcome everybody. I'm glad everybody is now here and that we can get together and talk about our upcoming trip. I wondered if any of you guys are having any questions or you're feeling anxious about anything that you want, you know, there are burning questions in your mind. I do apologize that I haven't been in better communication with you all. Most of you may know that my dad passed away last Saturday, so we just put him at his funeral and buried him on Friday. So hopefully we can get engaged and get moving through this now at a better pace.
Larry, can I say something?
Yeah.
I just want to say a huge thank you to Lisa for organizing some get-togethers with some of the team members here in Minnesota to talk about logistics, supplies, you know, things like that, things to expect because, you know, some of the people haven't been at a camp before.
Yeah.
And I absolutely was swamped with buying tickets and, you know, all the visas and, Lisa, thank you.
Oh, Cindy.
Thank you, Lisa. Appreciate it more than words can say. The only thing that was hard is that I wanted to be there with you guys, but I couldn't be.
We knew you couldn't, so we didn't invite you.
Yeah, thank you. That was good because, you know, I can't resist. I can't stay away.
I know. So we did not. We did not tempt you because we knew you had other responsibilities.
Yeah.
So it's been wonderful team building.
I'm very, very grateful for that you were able to share, especially with Becky and Deb, because I would love to have one-on-one time with everyone. But Larry, like you said, you can't always be there. So,
yep.
Larry, I guess.
Yes.
Because I haven't been at a camp before.
Yes.
I guess I had some questions about the curriculum.
Yes. Okay. Go ahead.
You know, do we bring all the supplies like the pencils and the construction paper and all that stuff?
That's a good question. What you should be doing, and we'll talk about this a little bit tonight, is looking through the curriculum and pick and choose the things that you want to do.
Right.
And make sure that you...
Like on that... Go ahead. Go ahead, there.
You have the supplies, the list of things that you need, okay? And I don't know whether we're going to do this as a team or whether we're going to do it individually, but you need to get a list of the things that you need that that Tomorrow Clubs is not providing. And in the very front of the curriculum there, there's something that says that there what Tomorrow Club will provide, what you should bring. And that what you should bring is really dependent on what you want to do in your class. It doesn't, if you don't want to do all the activities, obviously you don't need everything they suggested you bring. You should just bring the things that you, you know, whatever you're going to do in your class. So that I don't know if that answers your question or not. You really need to be, I guess, very judicious about what you end up bringing and what, you know, what you decide you want to bring along, because obviously, there's an awful lot of stuff if you bring everything they suggest. So it's much better to just go through that curriculum day by day, make a list of the things that you're going to do, and then find the supplies that are pertinent or apply to whatever you're going to do. Does that answer your question?
Deb, do you know which age level you're going to be teaching yet?
The older ones.
Yeah, so then you would look in that curriculum book on the website in the very front, and then look on, you know, participants' responsibility.
What is the older group called?
It is, I know it's kind of confusing. I just went through this with the people from Armenia. It is, it's the second, it's, you know, there's a mistake on the website because it's the second book. It's called Intermediate. But it's actually for the older kids. We can go to the website. We need to switch that around. I'm really sorry about that. I think that when Paul put those on the website, he wasn't sure himself because he doesn't usually teach English in the camps. But if you go to
the junior one says beginning and up. Where is it on the website?
Yeah. Here, go to trip preparation.
I'm gonna get there, here, and then we can look at it.
Oh, did you bring it up, Larry?
I'm bringing it up right now on the screen. You should be seeing
what
it.
What did you go to, Larry?
I went to right here. I just.
Are you showing this?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're seeing this on the screen, right? Yeah. Okay. Right here.
What did you go to get into there?
Yeah, that's one of the.
So if we go into advanced, it'll be right.
Let me look.
I think it's the intermediate. You know, if you open up to day one, it says which age it is.
Yes, it actually, it looks like it is. Well, it's junior.
That says junior. If you
wait, let's just wait until it loads.
The reason it's confusing is because, you know, originally it was supposed to be beginner, intermediate, and advanced, and somehow it got to be beginner, junior, and intermediate. Mm-hmm. And I don't know how that ever happened, but it's really confusing for people because, you know, intermediate normally would be like the middle group.
But on the website it says advanced.
Yeah, but if you go to page one of day one in the curriculum of that second one, yeah, which says, I think it's intermediate.
Yeah.
Let's go there, Larry. Let's go there and look. I had the same confusion with the Armenia people that I'm training.
So that's the issue, is that they're just, the links are just flip-flopped.
Okay.
That's what it is.
I'm going to go.
Yeah, that's all it is.
If you just hit the back button, you'll go to, okay, yeah.
But I'm going to open them both so that we can see what each one is. Okay.
Yeah, maybe go and...
Okay.
Show them exactly how you get in there, would you, Larry?
Sure.
So Deb knows.
No.
Yeah, I'm gonna open all of them.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, the way that you get the way that you actually get there is that you just go to the Tomorrow Club's website, and in the Tomorrow Club's website, it's tomorrowclubs.org/trip
yeah.
and then hyphen videos.
And then trip preparation.
Well, if you just put in the URL.
Trip preparation?
Oh, there it is. You can click on it.
You can just go to the URL there. Can you see?
Click on it.
I don't know if you can see that or not on my screen. Can you see it? I've got it. I actually got it highlighted on the top. You see that?
Training videos? Is that what?
Yep. Yeah. That's it. That's what it is.
Can you click on intermediate, Larry?
Yep. I did.
Do you have all three open?
This is the beginner here. I actually opened them all free. Or actually, this is.
Yes.
Okay. So this one right here.
That one is accurate.
That's the beginner. And actually, this is the next
one. You open beginner twice.
Okay. Just hang on. I'm gonna pause my screen so I don't confuse you. And then I'm going to, when I open it back up again, I'll tell you what everything is so that I know. So,
yeah. So make sure that one's not. Okay, yeah. So close one of those. Just close one, the one on the left, by the way.
Right, just go back here.
Yeah.
And then I'll get this
one. And then you want to, no, intermediate. Because it's really good block. So,
that is intermediate.
Well, it is, but like she was saying, intermediate generally denotes in between, but in this case, it's actually the last one.
Okay. this is loaded up. I'll share my screen again, and then you'll be able to figure out which is which. And it's just about.
Okay. What's Cindy?
Yeah.
What's junior? It doesn't
it's
say intermediate. It doesn't say
like junior what? Is like inter. It's the middle. It's the middle kids, like ages 10 to 12.
Okay.
And you're teaching the older kids, right?
Right. 12 or 16.
Larry,
so
can we go to the older? The older kids curriculum.
Yeah, I'm getting.
I think it's. Okay. See, I can't. Okay.
Because Larry sent me that.
The next one. The one for 12 or 13 and up.
Yeah, so they want to see you. So the last 10.
That's it right there.
Let's scroll to the. Sorry, so yeah.
That's beginner. That's for the 6 years old.
It's all lagging. It'll come through in a second.
There. This is the one we want right here. They call it intermediate, but it's actually for the oldest kids.
I'll go onto the website and change that so people don't get confused.
Yeah, but can you show Deb? Can you scroll down?
I'll figure it out, Cindy. If I can't, I'll contact Larry.
Right.
Okay, this is the one, though, that you need, Deb.
Okay.
The one you're looking at.
Okay.
Sorry about that confusion, you guys. I'll have Paul change that. I didn't realize that we redid the website this year. We have a brand new website, and actually Paul did the whole website. And when he put those in, he made a mistake.
Oh, he's human.
Okay. Now,
the site is nice, very nice.
As you can see right here, here's the things that it says
yeah.
bring. And
do you see that, Deb? That's what you would bring there.
Okay, question. Does this go... okay, we're having an eight-day camp, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
How many days does this cover?
It only covers four.
Yeah.
Larry, have we reviewed the schedule together yet?
No, but I actually looked at it. We're going to... I think what you're going to have to do, and we can talk about it, and you're going to have to just go back and review some things. It is it's a 7-day camp. Let me pull this up here. Let's see, Moldova schedule. Okay, so you can see that. Okay, now you can see this. This is Moldova that we're talking about, by the way. this on this day, day one, it'll be Thursday, the 23rd. Okay? I don't know if you can see that or not. Thursday, the 23rd. Basically, we don't do anything on this day. In fact, not all of us are even here. The people that are here will be me, Cindy, David, Karina, and Zelma. Okay, that's the people that will be there. So you're not really going to do anything at all. And then this day, on Friday, they're going to actually be leaving early in the morning. Okay, so there really isn't any requirements for 2 days. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we do have 3 days that we're probably going to have to do some reviewing of things. And believe me, you can go slow enough to make that last. It's not
hard. I never complete everything.
Yeah. So I would not be concerned that you don't have enough of material. I would be concerned that you have too much. Okay? Did that answer your
question? What if somebody gets to the end of day four? Do we have to create our own? Because this is the first time, you guys, we've never done a camp like this before. We're breaking new ground here.
What I would do if I were you, and I do this every day, I go back and I do a review of everything that I've gone over before, okay? Mm-hmm. And usually if you take your time, that takes a good 15 minutes to half an hour just to do the review. So you don't have a lot of time to cover things. And if you just, do it at a nice pace, I don't think this will be any trouble at all.
And I think you could even have a day, you guys, where you just share about Jesus, your testimony, some stories from your life. They love things like that. Share some things about your family's experiences in America. That's powerful, like your testimony and things like that. But probably the most powerful thing that you can do with them,
And I'm going to send this to you guys so you don't have to write it all down. Okay.
I have a question.
Yes.
I have one. So if just a logistic type thing with a quantity of supplies. So if there's 250 kids in the camp and there's 10 of us leading, so are we looking at possibly 25 kids per class, depending on how the ages split up?
Yep.
Like if we're bringing pencils and crayons or whatever.
Actually, I think there's 11 people. Let me pull that up and find out exactly how many people are here.
And Larry, do we all have our own interpreter?
Yeah, as far as I know.
He's going to have an interpreter for everybody so we can all have our own class, right?
Here we go. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we have 12, but Jesse's not, unless we can talk Jesse into speaking, teaching, but I don't think we're going to. Right, Jesse? Jesse, I know you're out there.
Jesse, you're going to be so sad if you don't, right? You'll be so sad.
But we have David now, so we really have 11 people.
Yay.
Yeah.
Perfect.
All right.
It's not really like it sounds, you guys. It's manageable
to
have that many kids.
Yeah, you can do
that. I mean, it sounds like a lot, but really it's not bad.
I wish I could have a six-year-old.
What did you say, Deb? What?
I thought I should have taken the six-year-olds instead of the older teens.
Yeah, well, they run circles around you, though.
They do. I still like that age group, though. I just, I love them.
Oops. Okay. Anything else that you're feeling anxious about? That you have questions about? Ask them now. Hmm.
What about the people that we're rooming with? Do we decide that before we get there?
Yes, we did, and I actually gave him a I gave him a tentative a rooming schedule. I don't remember when I did it, but I did give it to him. I'll have to look it up to you and send it out to you. So if you have
okay, thank you.
You have a an objection to it, then we'll. I think I put the younger girls together, and then I put it was Jeff and no, it was David and I were together, and I can't remember everybody, but I think that it worked fine.
If you could send that to us, Larry, that'd be great.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Any other questions? Thanks. Yeah. What do you want?
I just make sure you remember to jot that down.
Yeah. Well. All right. Again, if you miss a meeting, then I will be. It's this. I'm recording this again, and you can get it. I'll be sending it out to the email. Okay. One thing that I wanted to do, I tried to get a group text going because I think sometimes that would be better communication. And I wanted you to take a look at these numbers. I don't know if you can see it well or not, but I'm getting bounces on them, okay? And I don't know if everybody's cell phone number is correct. I don't know if you can see them or not.
Zoom in.
Mine is good.
Mine is wrong.
Not the valid one.
Okay, who's wrong?
612-247-46. They've got my
combination
of my home phone and cell phone.
I told Cindy that before.
Okay. Yeah, if something is wrong, you guys, maybe you want to tell Larry. He can fix it right now.
Larry?
Yeah.
Becky's cell phone is 612-2. That's it. 474690.
Oh, good. Okay.
Okay. That's good.
Okay. Is anybody else?
And that's wrong.
My home phone is 952-890-3252. So the 612 is wrong. No, for Becky, home phone.
Yeah, this one here.
The home phone, the next one. Yeah, it's 952.
No, not those. The first three.
Okay.
There you go. 952-8903. Bingo.
Lisa, is yours right? It is right, right?
Yes, it is. It's correct.
Does anybody know about Jerry's? Is that correct?
Oh, let's see. Jerry's. Let me see.
I can look it up here.
Do you want my home phone while you're doing that, Larry? This is Debbie.
Yeah, sure.
952-423-3967.
Okay. All right. That's it on that. Are you looking it up, Cindy?
Yeah.
Okay.
Jerry's is correct. Jerry's home or Jerry's cell phone is correct.
Thank you. Okay. All right. So I think one of the things that we want to do is to open in prayer, and I'm going to ask David to open us in prayer.
That's fair. Dear Heavenly Father, we come before you now, and we just ask that you would you bless this time, that you would give us clear communication, that you would help us to express everything that we need to talk about tonight, that you, if there are any questions or worries, that you would instill your peace into those hearts. Lord, I just thank you for this team. I thank you for all the people that you've assembled to go. We praise you for the blessing that it is to even go. So, Lord, we thank you that you hear us, and we just ask that you would be in our midst tonight as we work through these plans, Lord. In Christ's name, amen.
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 Okay. I want to see who I have here tonight for this meeting. Lynn's not here, right? But Karina is here. David is here. Zelma's not here. Cindy's here. Larry's here. Jeff's here. Lisa's here. Jerry's not here. Becky's here. David's here. Debbie's here. Lauren's not here, right?
No, she may pop in later.
Cindy's here. I'm here. David's here. Zelma's not here. Green is here. And Mike is not here. Okay, so just give me an idea who's here and who's not here. Okay, let's go back here. The things that we're going to cover tonight are kind of the firm up assignments and then what's purchased. And then we're also, let's see, not sure what, Jesse's just saying, I can hear your all of your questions.
Yeah, my audio quit through the whole prayer, but then it came back.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know why.
Maybe that's what happened to Jesse. Did you ladies hear the prayer?
Yeah, we could hear him clearer than we can hear Larry.
Wow, I didn't hear one, only the very first words, and then it all went away. Oh. That probably happened to Jesse, too.
Well,
so it's back, though.
I didn't hear anything. And he looks like he's willing to help out the older kids as well. Any group as needed. So he
can't communicate what he's saying.
But he's saying he will. I would be willing to help out with
all. Right. But I just want to make sure that he can hear us.
That's great. All right. So we're really going to go over assignments, and we'll talk about how to share your faith, because you may get a chance to do that. And then also, we will try to firm up all the supplies and what needs to be purchased and so forth. Maybe you guys already did some of this. The goal, again, is to from participating in this.
There's Jesse.
Oh, there he is. Hey, Jesse.
Hi, Jesse.
He's not talking.
He said he's
not working. It's not working, I guess. Yeah.
Is he the one from the
Yeah, he's on.
I just was setting on his computer.
He's actually, anyway, our goal is to strengthen or start a tomorrow club. In this particular camp in Moldova, we're just going to try to promote tomorrow clubs through the camp itself, because it's not like a traditional camp that we typically do. Okay, we're going to have 250 kids from all over Moldova, and it's going to be an opportunity to actually get that word to go out as they go home. About half of them are not going to be churched or Christian at all. So 125 kids are probably non-believers. It's a pretty cool thing. Also, encourage the local church. Of course, that's one of our primary things that we want to do is encourage the local church. I want to take some time to pray. Last time we put some prayer requests together about visas, and also we wanted God to give us the words to speak in Russia. And then also Moldova, we wanted to have a bond, make money, and then also that the kids would be able to know the truth and be able to understand those things. Do we have any other prayer requests we'd like to add at this point, especially if you're feeling anxious or anything, with things that are coming up? Karina, are you on the, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, will you pray about the visas? And then David would pray about that God will give us the words to, and then Jeff, will you pray that our team would solidify? And then somebody want to pray for the kids' hearts to be.
I will.
Okay.
I will.
All right. Well, then what?
Give us the words of
To, so that we would have the words to, that, so that the kids could understand.
Okay.
Okay. Well, Karina, why don't you start, and then Cindy, you can finish.
Okay. Okay. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we know that that you know the future, Lord, and you know where the visas will be sent to and who will be reading them, Lord. We just ask for your favor and ask, Lord, that everything would go through smoothly, Lord. I just pray that we would get the visas in time, Lord, so that everybody could get onto the trip, Lord, as you want them to, Lord. Please just, I just pray that we could work on them, and Lord, that it would just turn out according to your will, Lord.
Lord, we also ask for just your spirit when we're there to just come upon us and give us the words to say, Lord, we so desire for your truth to be communicated effectively and accurately, Lord. So we humbly ask you to impart those things to us. That is, it won't be by our power or our choosing or anything that we are deciding, but that you would fill us with what you want us to pour out. As far as the words we are able to communicate, Lord, I pray that there would be open. Those who receive would have softened hearts to hear these things.
Father, we thank you, Lord, for the wonderful bonds we have in Christ Jesus because of what he's done. And a team coming together, we know you, and you know each one of us, and you care so very much about these children from Russia and Moldova and young teens. And so we, Lord, ask you to work in each of our lives personally. We pray, Father, that you would help us to guard our time, guard our hearts, that we would be in personal prayer and personal reading of your word, Lord, just so that will help all the more our unity in Christ. And also for the national people there in Moldova and Russia, as we work with them, Father, that again, you go ahead of us and you're working with them and preparing the way. So we pray, Lord, for a wonderful peace and a wonderful excitement and joy you'll give each of us, and also protect us from now till then, the things that can come to bother us and harass us, worry us, and stress us, that we lay these things at before you, Father, and to take care of them. In your name, amen.
Lord, we thank you so much that you hear our prayers, Lord. We thank you for your great love, Lord, and we thank you for our salvation. And Lord, I pray that you would just fill each one of us to the fullest, Lord, with your Holy Spirit, Lord, and Lord, work through us in a mighty way to bring the gospel to those children. Lord, I pray that you would fill each one of us with your love, Lord, so that we can share that love with the children. And Lord, they would feel it and they would know that it's coming from you, Lord. Mm-hmm. Lord, I thank you for every single person on this team, Lord. I thank you that you've handpicked each person. And Lord, we are so grateful for this opportunity that you've given us to go to this nation where the people are so hurting and they so desperately need you. And I just pray, Lord, that you would go before us, prepare the way, prepare the hearts of all those precious kids and teens and young adults that we're going to be working with, Lord. Open their hearts to the gospel, Lord, we pray in Jesus' name. We just plead the blood of Jesus over all of us, over the camp. And, Lord, we just ask you now, Lord, that you would just do a mighty work through this camp. And, Lord, that many, many would be saved because of it. And, Lord, we pray that in everything we do, your name would be glorified first, Lord. So please, Lord, go before us now. Prepare the way. Prepare every person who's going to be a part of this camp to be ready to minister to the children and to all of the people that are going to be present there. We love you so much, Lord. Thank you again for hearing our prayers. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, everyone, for praying. Jesse, to answer your question about what you would be doing, Michael, the camp coordinator, did not tell me specifics on what you would do, but he does have work for you if you decide that you want to do that. He didn't really, wasn't specific about what it was. So you could sure use me to help with the kids, because 250 kids.
You can come help us out, Jesse.
You look like you'd be able to handle a 16-year-old circus maker.
Yeah.
But, you know, just kind of knowing what I know about Moldova, I mean, they need help, all the help they can get. So, I mean, Larry, are you wondering, Jesse, like what kind of tools and things to bring for the tasks he has for you? Or not necessarily?
You'd have to type it.
You just have to type it, Jesse.
I think you might.
I think also if you use your speaker, actually you're called in on the telephone. If you change it to mic and speakers, I think you might be able to actually get on the call. We'll move on and then you keep going and we'll
okay. Yeah. I saw that, Jesse. Thank you. Good.
Okay. All right. This is a thing that I found, and I think it's a very good way to share your faith. And one of the things that last year we had two opportunities. We had two times that we shared with people in July and August in Moldova. And between July and January, the people that we shared with and presented the gospel died. Because I've been praying for those people, specifically, you know, since we left. It was an older captain, and then it was another older lady who was more or less kind of on her own. She was pretty much blind, and they died. And, you know, God doesn't take us here by mistake. And I think all the people that we come in contact with, you need to be really aware of this. I'll send this out to you guys so you don't have to write it all down. But there is, up here in the top when I send this out, there is a place where you can actually go. Oops. You can go and see more information about how to share your faith. Okay. And I'll come back to that if you are writing it down. But it's a little pamphlet, and it's basically there's some dialogue around these questions and when you use them. And you will, even through an interpreter, be able to talk to people about Christ, talk to the kids, maybe talk to people that are not actually involved with the camp. So I think this is a really, really good way to not, you know, be intrusive in the things that you ask. Just ask them five questions, and it tells you don't answer them. Just let them talk, because most people have things that they want to say if people just stop and listen to them. And then there's, of course, there's scripture that goes with it, and it tells you about how to prepare. Actually, if you have little books or little Bibles, you can write in there so you know where to go next. But most people now do a smartphone, so there's a way you can share there too. I don't know if you can actually see this or not. Can you see it, or is it completely?
Yeah. I can see it. Everybody else?
Yep. So I would suggest that you take a look at that, you know, and here's the questions that they tell you to start with. Basically, it's, you know, let me go back here to this. Do you have any kind of spiritual belief? And that's non-threatening at all. And then the next one really really gets to the crux of the matter, you know. To you, who is Jesus? That's a real diagnostic question. You can tell a lot of times from what people answer there where they are spiritually. You can tell exactly where they're at. A lot of them will say that, you know, the Son of God, or, you know, a lot of times they don't connect the fact that he's God, you know, and I think that's an important aspect that they don't. But you don't answer them there. You just let them talk, because that'll get them into this dialogue. And then do you think there's a heaven and hell? And then if you died right now, where would you go? And if what you believe were not true, would you want to know? Those are the things. And then you go through these verses and let them read them. You don't read them to them. You let them read them and ask them, what does that say to you? What does this say to you? And then you let them come to the conclusion of what it actually says to them, okay? And then you ask, if they go on, then you just ask them these questions. Are you a sinner? Do you believe Jesus died on the cross and rose again? Are you willing to surrender yourself to Christ? Are you ready to invite Jesus into your heart? And into your life. And that's the whole thing. There's much more that you can look at and background in there, but that's the approach, and it's really non-threatening. I've used it a lot of times when I went out with the youth at our church. We go out to the parks and talk to people, and it's a really good way to talk to people, because you're not threatening them, you know, at all. Any questions? Okay, great. Let's do it here. In here, the only thing that I want to highlight here is your packing lists and your gifts. Okay, these are all linked. So if you want to look at what you should bring, just a note: Sakhalin Island right now is 52 degrees, Cindy.
You know what? Yesterday, Sakhalin Island was the same temperature as Minneapolis all day long.
Really?
I was checking the two, and they were the same all day long. Can you imagine?
Wow.
I mean, that's right next door to Siberia.
Yeah. But, Jesse,
that's Minnesota.
Jesse looks out his door, he can see the people on Sakhalin Island.
Wow. Jesse, what is the temperature where you live right now? In Alaska.
You have to type it.
Maybe you can type it for us.
Oh, he can't speak. He can't speak because he's somewhere where he doesn't have Wi-Fi.
Wi-Fi,
but he's in a public place. You can
75. Type. That's pretty warm, actually.
Wow. Like what he said.
That's about what it is here.
Way too warm. 75. He says way too warm at 75.
That's probably hot for them.
Yeah, I think it is. Okay, so.
Wow, did you say it's 52 in Sakhalin right now?
That's what
that's
it is.
That's cold.
Yeah.
Oh, it's 84 in St. Paul, you guys. It's hot here.
Yeah.
Okay. One other thing is that you just triggered something in my mind. Moldova people, there's a lake there, okay? So.
No, we don't, Jesse.
They will be swimming if you should decide you want to.
Oh, dear.
I doubt that any of you will. But should you want to, there's a lake to swim. So that's in,
okay.
That's in. I'll be swimming. I don't care. Just the way it is.
I swim here. Sure, I swim.
Okay. Now, again, I'm just reiterate your responsibility right now is to be looking at your curriculum and find what you need. All right. Now, we're going to go through and try to figure out what we need to buy and what we need to put together. I just happen to have stuff that's left out, that I have leftover things from previous years, okay, believe it or not. And these are the things that I have. I don't know if you can see it or not. I have tons of stuff. The real question that I have, okay, I really have most of the stuff that we need. There's a couple things that we're going to have to add a couple to because we have 250 kids, where we typically don't have 250 kids. We have 125 or 100 kids. But as you can see, I have in history, I don't know if you can you see this okay or is it too small?
Where do you have all this stuff, Larry, at your house?
Yeah. At the end of the
wow.
At the end of the trip, I just went back and put it all together and inventoried it so that because I knew I was going to get it.
Wow. I thought did you bring it home from Moldova then?
I don't know how I got all of it.
Well, okay. Well, good. That's awesome because there's a lot of what we need right there.
Yeah. So, you know, for this is for American Day. Basically, I have everything that we need for American Day except probably the peanut butter and jelly. Okay.
I've got peanut butter and jelly.
We got it.
Okay.
Oh, great.
Thanks, guys.
And
the real question is, though, for me is, I'm going to take this stuff to Russia. Do I want to take this stuff from Russia back over to Moldova? You know what I'm saying? Because it's coming. I'll be going all the way across Europe, and then all the way across, back across. So now it might do me better just to send the stuff I have to you guys and let you take it instead of to me take it. You know, so you don't have to go out and buy.
Larry, can I ask you a question? Are you flying on Aeroflot the whole way? Because usually Aeroflot lets you take two bags.
I think so.
So maybe you can just bring it from Russia then if you don't have to pay for an extra bag.
Yeah. Okay, but these are the things I have. There are things that we're going to have to buy, but this is what I have. And some of it, I'm sure, will get trashed in Russia. Okay. And then, okay, so we'll go ahead and look at. Let's go ahead and look at. Let's see. I have a kind of a list of things that I would just. Forgive me. This isn't very organized, but it's just the way that I'm kind of thinking through the things that we need. Okay. This is Russia up here, and down here is Moldova, okay? And here's the assignments that I have, okay? Lynn actually wants to do 12 to 16, and you can just read down through it. I think I have Karina at 9 through 12, and David and Selma at 12 and 16, and then Cindy 6 to 9, me to 9 to 12, and Jeff 6 to 9.
Flexible. Yeah.
Actually, Jeff's going to do the music that today they said that Jeff, they have to have Jeff because they don't have a music leader. So I know most of you don't really care about this part of it, but there are some things that we're going to have to bring, the Russian people are going to have to bring. Like, we'll have to bring a volleyball net, and I have a volleyball net, but we'll have to bring poles, and we'll have to bring giant volleyball, probably two of those. Okay. All right. So let's go down and look at Moldova. This is Moldova here. The assignments. Let's make sure that these assignments are right. Lisa, I have you as a nurse. Jerry's not here. Her doing music. Becky, I have you doing devotional. And actually, yeah, so that I have that. David, I don't have you doing anything because you're a new ad. And Debbie, I have you coordinating supplies. And then Lauren, I don't have anything for Lauren. I don't have Jesse signed up for anything. Should I go ahead and sign you up, Jesse? I said yes, like this. Okay. What is going on? Hold on just a second.
Yeah, luggage would be good.
Okay.
Yeah, luggage and medical, that's
yeah. Good. Okay, so
at least I'd love to get out of it.
That's good.
Put luggage here. Okay. And look up some medical too. Okay. So then we have Cindy. I have you doing coordinating the supplies you need for English, and I'm going to do sports and drama. And Karina, I have you doing taking pictures again. Is that okay?
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Okay. Then I have luggage. Mike is going to have help, and David, we have to fit you to do something with that with you. Okay, so here's the things as far as, are these right first? Is everything right as far as you guys?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I think so.
Okay.
Everybody agree?
Yep.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, so what I did is I kind of blew out, I actually copied the Russian stuff over, and I put it in a spreadsheet. Basically, we can go down through and see what we need for each day. All right. For the registration, and that, if we look at the registration, Cindy, me, you, Karina, David will be doing that. And when I talked to Michael, he said that the registration takes a lot of time. If you look at this right here, on the first day, the registration takes from 8 to 12. Okay, so that's a lot of time. But one of the things that, I don't know if they have name tags, but I think we should try to plan on name tags, taking name tags to help with that.
Lisa, you've already taken care of that, yep. Right?
They're already, Larry and Cindy has the ones for Russia. I had the cardstock left from last year, so I just cut it up. And so we've got them all. Plus, I'm believing on 120 kids in Russia, so I gave Cindy extra.
Yeah. Yeah, so Larry, I have all our stuff for name tags. Plus, I have our gospel bracelets for Russia, too, from Lisa.
Oh.
Thank you, Lisa.
You're welcome. Yep, yeah, so I found a good...
That's something else.
The prices on the beads. Yep. So we got that's all taken care of for both camps.
Oh, wow. Praise God. Thank you. Thank you so much. Okay. So let's go back and go back to where was I? I can't think. Okay. I don't want to go there. Let me go back here. Well, there was supplies. Okay. So this first day. That we have, if we can look at the first day, we'll go back to this. Basically, there really isn't a lot to do on this first day, but I do have the giant volleyball things done. Actually, we have that. We're going to work on doing that for that day. So we need to make sure that those come along with us in when we go. The supplies that need to happen there are, we need cones to go out around the outside. We don't have to bring a net, and we don't have to bring poles because they have two volleyball courts, which is great. But we will need more cones than just just six. I probably need about 12. And I, in my inventory, I have four. So we need, we probably need about another, you know, five or so, six, maybe six cones. So this two over here means that you need to double what you need, since you, because you had at six.
You mean,
okay. Go ahead.
For Moldova, we have to double everything, is that what you're saying?
Well, not everything. We just have to double any,
but I mean,
any, the things that I have twos by here, those things are got to be doubled up, because we really don't have, we won't have enough. See what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, if we, even if I bring the stuff from Russia, all the stuff from Russia, we're still going to be short.
Okay.
So,
question with those with the cones. It may be explained to people that haven't been to camp before. I imagine the great big parking ones, yeah. You know, like
they're just
you know the little like 6-inch or 4-inch. Yeah. They're just little tiny cones that you can get at the what kids' toy store or Target or
yeah. I'm trying like to think if I even got them at the dollar store last year.
One thing that we could do, and maybe this is what something I should do. I was thinking. Oriental Trading Company is a good place to get a lot of stuff. Mm-hmm. And if we just kind of made a list of everything that we need, one person could kind of buy it, you know, or I could buy it and have it drop shipped to you guys so that you could bring it. So since I've done a real kind of thorough look at what's needed, you know, if you guys wanted to chip in, I purchase it and then have it drop shipped to you, and then you bring it, and you bring it over. That would save some effort. What do you think?
That sounds good.
Think about that. And I'll just put that I can do the order online, and away we go.
And if you want,
I just remembered I got those cones at Michael's last year, and they were cheap. I mean, there was a package of four for like $3.99, something like that. Just FYI for, yeah.
But we don't get there until the 24th, Lisa.
Oh, that's right, because we're.
So we won't even be there on the 23rd.
Okay.
Yeah.
Is that a Thursday? Let me look here.
Yeah, Thursday, if we look.
Yeah, you guys will be there for Friday the 24th, but you arrive on the 23rd. Oh, no, you arrive on the 24th, right, because you have your overnight on the 23rd.
Right.
Yeah, we'll be getting...
So we can't be bringing the cones is what I'm saying.
Right.
Because we don't be there, we won't be there until unless you switch that to a different day.
Well, okay.
The kids are getting there, Larry. I thought I heard the kids are getting there on the 24th.
No,
that's their arrival.
They're actually, I think they're getting there on the 23rd.
Really?
Unless I'm wrong.
Okay.
Okay, so let's go.
We should probably find out for sure.
Okay. Did you talk to Michael about that?
See? Well, not since the very beginning, but you know, he was telling me that we could leave the U.S. the 22nd or the 23rd,
okay,
either one. So I had everybody leaving on the 23rd.
Okay. Let's go back here then. So if let's see. Okay, so we don't really need anything here, and I can probably take care of this part of it. We'll just need, we are going to need some more. Here's something that I really would like to have, a megaphone, and you can get them fairly cheap. They're just little, I've seen them at five and below, you know, you can get from 10 or 10 bucks, but they really, really come in handy, because when you're trying to get the attention of those kids, It's next to impossible. So I would like to have one of those that would really come in handy. Actually, it would come in handy if we could have two of them. Because if we're going to be running two courts at the same time, and you know, if people are trying to get attention on one court, that would be great to have those. I don't know if someone could look into getting, see if they could find one, or see if they can, you know, price them out at least.
I'll check, Larry.
Oh, thank you. Thanks, Lisa.
I'll check.
So your Lisa's going to check the megaphones.
I will.
How about the whistles?
Yeah.
Do you want me to get the whistles, Larry?
Yeah.
Or do you have?
Sure. Let me go. Let me see what I got in my supplies. I think I have some whistles here.
Yeah, whistles.
Where is it? Do you see it?
Oh, whiffles.
Oh, yeah. Under sports supply. Oh, no, it's wiffle bat. Never mind.
Okay. Yeah, go ahead, Cindy. Mm-hmm. I would say that we're going to need, for dodgeball, for sure, we're going to need at least two or maybe three. Okay. Let's get back to here.
Whistles?
Yes, whistles.
Do you want me to get those, Larry? I can put those on my list.
Yep.
Three? Okay.
Actually, I have six, but that's okay.
Oh, so we don't need any then, right?
No, I said we need. This is where I was actually blowing out.
Oh, you have six there. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I have. This is.
Oh, what's then?
If you take this and double it, that's what.
And double it.
You need 12 cones.
Six whistles?
Yeah.
Wow.
Three.
Do you want me to get six whistles?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay. Then we, the volleyball, the giant volleyballs, we need some of those. And I know that we probably need a lot, two to three, but they always break. I mean, they always get holes in them. Mm-hmm. So. Somebody do that.
Who's getting the cones, Larry?
I'll take care of that.
Because we need 12.
Yeah.
Do you want me to get some?
I have, Cindy, I have this. Actually, I have this right here.
Let's see how many you have.
I have four, it looks like.
Do you want me to get some more?
Yeah.
Okay. So I can get eight of the cones.
Okay.
Maybe Karina and I can each carry four. Because okay. I think they come in packages of four. It's not a big deal.
Okay.
Okay, I got it on my list.
Okay, let me get back over here. So this is cones. All right. How about the volleyballs?
Why don't us Minnesota group? Why don't we add that onto our list? Because you know when they're deflated, those big plastic ones, you know those the ones we had brought to Ukraine the last time seem to work okay. So we'll mm-hmm. pick up a couple of those. Do you want two more? Or three?
I'd like to have three.
Okay.
The reason why is because. They always get holes in them when we're
okay.
We're left. So who's got their name on that?
Anybody? You put Lisa on there. Then be Lisa, Becky, Debbie.
Lisa, Debbie. But one thing too. One thing too is because of you guys getting there late. See, is there anybody? You'll have to give them to Cindy. Cindy will have to carry them because you're not
okay.
You're not actually going to be there on day.
Except I have to take them to Russia and then back to Moldova.
Cool. Unless we.
Is that okay?
Yeah, that's fine with me. Unless it's not fine with you.
It's like it's not going to hurt me. I'll go for it.
No.
Maybe you should just change our flight, Cindy, to a day sooner than that.
You know what? We can move stuff around. It always all works out.
It does.
You know, we've got Karina, we've got Zelma, and, you know, we've got five of us going from Russia back to Moldova. Surely we'll be carrying, you know, some of that stuff with us. No problem.
Yeah. Okay. So, the next thing is the dodgeball. So, all these supplies right here and dodgeball, we need to double it. Okay, the cones we don't have to worry about because we already got it. We already got the whistles. We already got the megaphones. But the kickballs, we need 12.
Do kickballs come deflated?
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, you have to deflate everything. That's what we do, and that brings up another thing. I'll be bringing the stuff to blow up the kickballs. Let's see here, my supplies. I think I have a whole bunch of them. If I have 6 air pumps, I have 13 needles, so there's no problem. There's no problem blowing things up. Okay, so let's go back. Oops, sorry.
Lisa, I'm out in left field on these game things, so just say whatever you think we should, you know, do, and we'll divvy it up at our meeting.
That sounds good.
Speak for us.
I will do that.
Okay.
Because we don't know what
we're close. Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. We can discuss all this stuff at our meeting, too.
Sounds good.
So, can you guys bring, like, 6 kickballs?
All right, we'll put it on there, 6 kickballs.
Okay, chicken relay. We have the kickballs. We really don't need anything for that. That's good. The yogurt, really, there's nothing that you need for that because, actually, I probably need some bandanas. Let's see how many I have. I think I have some bandanas somewhere here.
We had so many of those last year. Tons. Tons.
Yeah, I have 13, so it's all good. Don't worry about that.
Okay.
Okay. Let's go back to this. So we don't need anything for that. Yogurt, the king of the jungle. The only thing that we would need there is I think it would be nice to usually we put the words up, but I would really like to have maybe an audio track. Because, and I don't know if you remember this. Oh, you weren't at the camp, Cindy. But the kids, if you have an audio track to go along with it, with music and stuff, it's actually nicer. So just a PowerPoint for that. That's all we really need. So and I'll take care of that. This is all my responsibility. So unless I think, hang on just a second, I get so confused with who's doing what. Names, assignments. Who is doing music in Moldova?
What, Larry?
Who is doing the music in Moldova? Jerry's doing it?
I think,
Jerry.
Yeah, Jerry.
So I'll contact Jerry, and she'll have to be – I'll let her do that part. And actually, I'm also going to give David – I'm going to give David all the AV stuff.
That's what happens when you're not there. You get signed up for stuff.
Say something nice. You wanted something else?
No, I didn't.
We didn't say anything.
Drama or something?
No.
Okay, well, so we don't need anything for there. Nothing for Leapfrog. House on Fire, we just need to go over that. Basically, there's no nothing here. Directions, I have, meaning the American Day, basically I have everything for American Day. If you want to add some, if you want to add some things to that, what I have, you can. Okay.
So you don't have those little small flags for each student?
No, I don't.
Right, Larry? Okay, so if we got those, that would be okay?
Yeah.
Okay.
Larry, are you on Houses on Fire right now?
We went past it. You want to talk about it?
No, I just kind of lost track of where you are for some reason.
Yeah.
On here.
There really isn't anything that we need other than a background. We just need to assign people to do it. We need actually six people. Six people for this. Maybe I should assign people to do these things too. So, six participants and a translator. We need a director, and three actors. We need a total of six.
I'll be one of the people, wherever you want
us. I will too.
Yeah, wherever you want to put us in, Larry.
Okay. Yep. So Cindy, Lisa, David.
Do we need to bring anything for that, Larry?
No. The only thing that you need there is a background. And actually, I'm going to project the background.
Okay.
I went out and actually got a house that's on fire. So
that'd be great. You know,
project that up there and it'll add whole ambience of House on Fire. So we still
I think Becky will be very good in that. I think Becky should be in there too.
Okay. I can emote.
You'll be wonderful, dramatic.
She would be.
Yes, yes. And Debbie, too.
There we go.
Yes.
It's super fun. It's really so fun.
Good, fun. Sign me up. I want to do fun.
Okay, so we got Cindy, Lisa, David, Becky, Debbie. And Jeff, guess what? You get to do this. You know who else is good? Michael Kappen was good at this. Did you see that? Did you see Mike? Yeah. More than merrier. I'm gonna put Jeff in this too. All right, Jeff, you're in there. Okay, let's go back up here. Actually, let's start to put some people's names to things. To run this thing, to run the sports, I need. I'm going to need six referees.
Referee?
Yep.
You have to understand the rules.
A referee, basically, you don't do anything. All you do is you get the ball, you take it, and you make sure that it gets back on the court. And when it goes out, you tell the head guy, was it a point or not? So we need six people.
Well, you had me at you don't do anything, so I'll sign up for that.
Well, if that's on day one, we aren't going to be there, remember?
Oh, September.
You've got us down there. You've got Lisa and I down there, too. We aren't going to be there on day one.
Yeah, those are just for supplies. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is it's all of us that are coming from Russia. We're going to be doing that. Now, this one, we need six people, two referees, one leader for each one. And this is dodgeball. What you do in dodgeball, you don't actually do anything. You just have to make sure to tell the person, like if they get hit, you're out, okay? It's too much for one person to handle. the person who's the head person. So you just stand on one side and point to the person they're out.
Debbie and I can tell people they're out.
Okay, good. Thank
you. We like to tell people where to go.
Who else? Jeff, you're in there.
Yeah, I can do that.
Who else? David?
Are you looking for referees?
Yeah.
I can do it.
Okay. So we got, all right, so we got five people.
I think that Karina would like to do some of these. I think she had to get off because she had a huge exam that was due at midnight.
Hey. Am I still there, here? Karina? Here. Yeah, I'm still, do you hear me?
Oh, you're still here, okay.
Yeah, I turned gray, but.
Okay.
But yeah.
So we're going to put you.
Well, I do want to take photos, though, of the sports, too.
Oh, true.
Okay, we'll take you off. Wonder if Lauren would want to do this.
I mean, as long as she doesn't have to, like get down and dirty, you know, I think she'd be okay. What do you think, Lisa?
You know, if she can't, if she's not feeling well, I'll be her sub, you know, or we can switch off.
Let's put her on there for it.
Okay.
Okay. So now the next one is the chicken relay. Basically, there's nothing on that. The only thing that we do need is boxes. We need four boxes because we have to. The game basically is you put kickballs. I'm going to use kickballs between your legs, and you have to run down the other end and drop the ball in the box with your legs, and then you have to go back the other way. And drop it in the box. So we need two
Wouldn't they have boxes at the camp?
Probably, yeah. Well, sometimes it's hard to get that. For some reason, they don't have them. And I don't really know. And we could actually use those. We could use four boxes. Actually, we could use five boxes for the head under the box. That's something that we could definitely. So the boxes that you can get, like at Home Depot or U-Haul, we can just fold them up in it.
How big are they, Larry?
Huh?
How big are the boxes?
It depends on what size you get. They're like this by this, but they're folded.
I mean, do you actually carry those overseas? I didn't know that.
Well, maybe we can just find something else to use. That'd be cool. We'll just let it go then.
Larry?
Yeah.
Jesse wanted to know if the mission balls that he got would work for the kickballs.
Yeah.
They'd be great.
Two birds with one stone. There you go.
Oh, great.
Mission balls, kickballs.
How many does he have? Did he say?
He's typing. Mm-hmm. Well, he can talk now, I think. He's lit up. Oh, wow.
Ooh.
Yeah, we don't have to have any balls.
Wow.
Oh, good. All right, cross that up the list.
That's awesome. And then you'll deflate all of them, Jesse? Oh, that's awesome. The kids will love it.
What's a mission ball?
Great. Thank you, Jesse.
What's a mission ball?
Aren't they like a soccer ball with Bible verses or something like that?
Really? Cool. Bible verse. All right, Jess.
He's typing.
Super de duper.
Larry, I gave you one for a gift once. Do you remember that?
Yeah, is that what you're talking about? It's like it's a soccer ball.
I think so. Well, I thought the one I gave you was a soccer ball. They probably have different ones, but it had Bible verses on it, didn't it?
Or
it had the gospel message on there or something.
It had Bible verses on it.
It was a long, long time ago.
And he's typing, I think. Mm-hmm. Oh. Yeah.
Oh, that's what it is. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's
awesome. I've seen those before. They're perfect. That will be super fun to have.
And he's getting them in a room, and that's what they're speaking there. So that's a fantastic tool. Okay. Wonderful. So we don't need the kickballs. I'll just put Jesse.
Okay.
Oh, that's great.
Okay. We don't need anything here. This we will need. There's things that we need for the yogurt thing, and maybe they have them, but we always need a tarp to go under the actual thing where the stuff the yogurt gets on the ground.
I can bring a tarp.
Yeah, let me see.
Larry.
Yeah, let me see. I might have one. I think I actually have one. I thought I saw a tarp in here.
Oh, yeah, down at the bottom, one small brown tarp.
Oh, okay.
Is that the one?
Yeah.
Is that big enough?
No, we need more. Because it messes the floor up big time. And they don't like their floors getting messed up. I don't know why, but... So we probably need a couple tarps. I actually said I think we need two. Let's get back to my little slides. One tarp to go under the kids, 12 large garbage bags to use around the outside of them. I guess they would have garbage bags, but pack of wet wipes, roll of toilet paper, roll of paper towel, and then spoons, which we can get there. We do need, I would say, if we could bring any another tarp, that would be good, because we can also use the tarp for the head under the box thing.
I'll get it, Larry.
Okay.
I got it on my list here.
I would say get...
And I'd be happy to bring the garbage bags, too. I'll just flatten them out and put them in my suitcase.
Okay.
You need 12?
Yeah. You need... What
do you need for Russia, too, Larry?
Yeah. Yeah, we will need them for Russia, too.
Same number? Or six.
Well, what it is we're only going to do this with the same number, because it's not going to be doubled up. It's just the same number of kids.
Okay.
You put the mm-hmm. you put, it's to go over their clothes so they don't their clothes don't get all messed up.
I see.
Okay. We'll need a lot of people. I think you need 3 to 4 people to help running it, and then you'll also need people to help clean up, because it's really messy. So we probably need about four people to work on that. It's messy.
Well, I'll do whatever.
Yeah, we'll do.
I can bring the spoons. I have tons of plastic spoons.
Okay.
We can get them over there, Cindy. Don't bring any.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
And same with paper towels?
Yeah, we can get all those things. We just need to make sure. The wet wipes are probably the one thing that they may not have. Because there's kids, it just gets all over them, and they don't like getting messy. Hopefully we won't get them completely messy. But.
I think I have some, Larry.
Okay.
That I got from Quentin's warehouse.
Okay, so
I'll check.
Let's see, who didn't I assign anything much anything yet to? Let me see here. No.
Oh, Jerry's not been in on some of the fun yet.
Yeah, we're going to...
Jerry will do whatever, too.
Yeah, she will.
She will.
So we're going to put Gary and Zelma on this.
Yeah, Zelma will bring some things, too, Larry. If you want to, like, we can assign her some things, and I can call her and tell her.
All right.
Actually, I'll be talking to her tomorrow.
Okay. Let me get back here.
So do you want to assign her some things? What do we have right now that's up in the air?
Hang on just a second. Let me go back over here. I just need her. Right now, I just need her to, she can bring a pack of wet wipes.
Okay. I'll just have her do that. I think I usually bring a pack anyway, but,
okay.
You know, we'll need one for both camps. And we'll probably need two for Moldova, right?
Yeah. Okay. And then, so the people that are actually working in this, Jerry, Selma, Lauren, no, yeah, I guess I'll, David. Get that one. You're actually going to run it. And who else?
How about Michael? Can he bring some stuff?
Yeah, I'm just, these are the people that are actually going to help clean things up.
Oh.
Okay. All right. So let's go down to the next thing. Leapfrog race. There's really nothing that you have to bring there. We already did everything we need to do. And we talked about this. We have everybody there. American Day. Small flags is all you're bringing. And who's doing the peanut butter and jelly?
We've got peanut butter and jelly.
We've got that covered.
Thanks, you guys. That's awesome.
Okay, so that's Vicky. And Debbie. Okay, I have two wiffle balls and two wiffle bats.
How about bats?
I only have two. If you look at my supplies... let's see where it is. I have two wiffle bats. That's it.
So what more do we need more?
Yeah. We'll need more.
And balls too?
Yeah, let me go back. I'm confusing myself.
Can we ask Michael to bring two wiffle balls and bats?
Yep.
You think? Larry, the two that you have, are we going to have those in Russia?
Yeah. We actually need one more in Russia. You need three stations.
Well, I can get one.
Yeah.
I'll bring one back.
Okay. And I have one set of bases. And what I'm figuring in this is actually three stations. That's what I'm figuring here.
So you need two more sets of bases then?
Yeah, I have one set. I have one bat set of bases, so I need another set of bases. And
okay.
I have this doubled in.
And extra wiffle balls in case they vanish.
Yeah.
All right. So why don't the Minnesota people take care of that?
That's a good idea because those are lightweight too.
Yeah. Set of bases and like a set of six balls.
Larry, do we need a large American flag?
Yeah.
Larger size?
Actually, I have one.
Okay.
Actually, in my inventory under American Day, I think I have a flag. I have four smaller flags and one large American flag.
Oh, good.
I don't know what the one bundle flags. I don't know what that is. But I have three wiffle, three bags. Oh, that's bag three. wiffle balls and bases, five wiffle balls, and five. Oh, I have five bases, so it's first through. One, two, three, four. Pitcher and home, so need two more of those. Okay, let's go back. All right. I have a PowerPoint for the 4th of July. Who is going to do? Do we have somebody to do the history for American Day? Jeff can do that.
Who's a history buff out there?
Jeff?
I am.
Jeff.
Oh, great. Oh, that's what we need, Jeff.
That's a very big topic, so I might need some people to help me.
I have it.
All right. You can just touch on each thing. Like, remember when Janzi shared, like, about Thanksgiving and our holidays and stuff? She did such a great job on that. You know, she just touched on each one a little bit.
Yeah. Okay. All right, so the dramas, this we need actors, and actually I have some T-shirts, I believe. Let me get my supplies. I thought I had T-shirts in here. Anybody see T-shirts? Black and white T-shirts.
Oh, you mean like black T-shirts, Larry?
Yeah. I thought I had them.
Maybe each person can bring their own black shirt that's going to be a part of that skit.
Yeah.
I don't see them on there.
I know.
Is anybody else? Mm-hmm. We're probably looking right at it and don't see it.
I was almost positive I had them in there. I don't know. I thought for sure. Oh, I don't see it. All right, let's keep going. Wrong place. All right, so who's going to do this? Who's going to do this skit? It's three acts.
I'll be part of it. I can do part of it. I did that one last year, and I think or maybe that was a couple years ago. And I had the purse. I had my purse stolen, so I provided the little purse.
Yeah, this one's
I can do that again.
This is the one, I don't know if you remember. This is, I'll show you what it is.
Oh, Jesus on the cross?
No, I'll show you what it is right here.
Oh, there's Jesus on the cross.
It's this one right here. The two actors approach an imaginary chasm in the center of the stage. One actor approaches from the stage left, the other stage right. Jesus is in the center, stage behind the chasm, facing away from the stage. Actor one has a props. They have a prop, a white T-shirt, and the action is to walk up to the chasm and almost stumbles in the hole. Actor two props is a white, wears a black T-shirt with a white T-shirt underneath. In the action, he walks up to the chasm, waves at the other purse. Other actor recognizes the hole from the other actor's warnings. This actor then picks up an imaginary rock, tosses it into the chasm. Each actor watches the rock fall, then turns their ears towards the rock and hears the rock. At the bottom of the chasm, one of the actors should whistle to make the sound. So it's basically two actors coming from either side and Jesus in the middle. And then somebody has to explain it. So we one of the actors has to explain. So we need three people.
I could be one of them.
Okay, Karina?
Probably not Jesus, though. Okay. Maybe that should be a male.
Yeah. Was that a joke? Okay, so Karina. Who's going to be Jesus? Last David's typecast is Jesus.
Okay.
David's Jesus. Now we need somebody on the other side. One comes from one side, one comes the other. They can't get across. Jesus comes up, and then one's able to climb over to the other side. So we just need one other person. Should I put Michael on there? Yep, Mike just got it.
Yep.
Done. Okay. Okay, here's the next one. The water balloons. We need... we need a 500 to 600 water balloons filled. Need four launchers. I guess probably four. Actually need to double that. 300 to 500. That seems like a lot. Yeah, maybe it's not. So you need almost 1,600 water balloons filled up. Because if we do... If we do eight stations. So we need water balloons, a lot of them. And we need the launchers. We need about, I would say, five to eight launchers. And then we also need sheets, for one for every 10 people. And then we need 4 liters for each launcher. Because it takes two people to... One to hold each side, and then one person to pull it back, and then, okay, so.
Jesse says he can get the water balloon.
Okay. Would be Jesse. Okay.
I can definitely work with that sheet.
I have.
Are they going to fill the water balloons for us with the team over there?
Yeah, we actually filled them the night before. Okay. So we need a bunch of launchers. I think I have a couple launchers. Let me go look them in.
Why don't we plan on getting two of those, Lisa's group?
Okay. I have two water balloon launchers. What I have. So let me get back to supplies. I probably need 2 to 4 more.
You're speaking up for us girls, and whatever you tell us, we'll bring.
Right.
Correct, Mundo?
Oh, thank you, guys. Thank you.
Okay, so we need 4 liters for each, and if we have, basically everybody has to help with this.
Everybody.
That's great. Everybody helps. Okay, the next one is the head under the box. We need 2 6-foot long tables placed about 2 feet apart, 3 tarps for under cover each table. We already are bringing one tarp. We probably need more.
Well, why don't we stick another tarp under Lisa's group?
We'll need 3. We will definitely need 3 because you have to cover. You saw it, right? Did we do it in Ukraine?
Yes.
Okay.
We did. Yes.
So you know exactly how it has to be covered up. There has to be like two to go to the middle, and then like the head kind of on an angle. You just have to make sure nobody can see anything. Okay, and then we have different balls, so that'll work. And then we need, I think you need about 5 helpers for that. Need 2 people on either side, need somebody to run it, and then you need somebody to go get the people. So,
I'll help with that. That's really, that one's really fun.
Yeah.
Let's put Lauren on there too.
Okay.
So what do we need to bring for this one, Larry?
Tarps. That's all you need.
Huh?
We need
tarps.
We need tarps, but then we need a bucket or a blanket or something to cover the balls. But most of the time, they have them. You know, we only need 5.
Yeah. We only need 5 from them.
Buckets. So it's not a big deal. Okay, so we got Lisa and Lauren. Who else? We need to...
Let's put Jerry in there.
Yeah, good idea. That's a fun one.
This is a very
put Debbie and I wherever. Wherever old ladies fit.
That makes
grannies.
How about Michael?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Okay. That's enough. Somebody, who's gonna run this thing? Somebody has to run it.
How about David? Can David run that one?
Yeah, he can run it.
Yeah.
He's seen it so many times. He do it in his sleep.
Yeah. I've never done that one.
You've never done that one?
I mean, I've seen it, but I've never done it. I've seen it.
Yeah. You don't want to pick David. You don't want to pick the little kids. We did it one time, and a kid was too young. He was like 6 or 7 years old, a little girl. And I picked her. I'm going, oh, I don't know what's going to happen. And when that box came off, she saw the head, and she burst out in tears. She ran away.
It's pretty shocking.
Yeah,
it's pretty shocking.
9 or... Above 9 years old. Typically, the squirreliest kid that you can find is the one that you want to do because you want to scare that. You have the demons out of them. Okay. So now, we are on Heaven's Gate. That takes the... Do we need launchers? Yes, we do.
Okay.
If you can bring 2 to 3 more launchers, that would be great, Jesse.
Do we have some now, Larry?
Yeah, we do. I have 2 launchers.
You have 2.
Yeah.
Does anybody else need to bring one, Larry, or is that it?
We're going to bring 2 from our side, Cindy.
Okay, so we don't have to worry then.
Yeah. So we're good, but he's going to bring 2 more. I think those will be a big hit. Okay. Heaven's Gate, there's
there he is going. Does a voice come through there? Do they hear us?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Uh-oh.
That was right. Okay.
I thought launchers was lawn chairs.
Where did you guys go?
You are good.
Are you guys laying on the ground?
Are we what?
Are you laying on the
yeah,
ground?
Yeah, they're laying on the ground.
All we can see is...
Yeah, we've been stretching.
All we can see is the
light. We've got our backs, so we're working our stretchers.
Mary, in about 10 years or so, you'll know why.
You'll understand what back problems is about. But I won't bring any lawn chairs, okay?
Cindy, your back should never, ever bother you. You know why? You got an in-house chiropractor. He can give you an adjustment.
Well, that's true.
I know of a good chiropractor, Becky.
So do I.
He's going to need to straighten us all out before we leave, Cindy.
Yeah, that's right. He will be happy to do that. Everybody can come over.
You should.
That sounds like a good plan.
You should have seen him in Moldova.
No, I mean it.
He had about 10 people lined up back to back to back. He was giving adjustments.
I know.
Right down.
He likes to do that.
Right down the line.
Popular man.
Yep.
Okay, so I think this one we need St. Peter, we need Jesus, and we need three different people. Okay, we need.
I'll be one.
Who's?
I'm different.
Who said that?
I said Becky.
Becky, okay.
He's different.
You are different, Becky.
I am different. I know. Don't you love my Lauren Bacall voice?
Yes, it's very...
Yeah, sexy, right?
Uh-huh. Yes, it is. Uh-huh.
I sound like a smoker.
Okay, so David is Jesus, and we need a St. Peter. I guess it has to be Jeff or... I guess it could... It could be Jesse.
Jesse don't have glasses.
Jesse.
I can do that one, Larry.
Okay.
So unless Jesse wants to do it.
No. We need a male to be St. Peter.
Oh, Jesse is good. You can put me on there.
Okay.
I mean, unless somebody else wants to do it.
We need.
Go for it, Cindy.
Okay.
We'll be good.
We need a girl.
We need
okay,
a young.
So I can bring my own black and white T-shirt.
Okay.
Well, you have to have a black and white T-shirt.
This actually... Actually, there needs to be three males in this. Because there's a kid, there's a young kid, and then a guy who actually beat up their kid, and then another female. That's the... let's see.
Oh, do we just need one female?
Yes.
Yeah, Becky will have fun doing that. I'll let her do it. I've done that one before.
Okay.
Do I have to have a black T-shirt?
Yes.
Do you have one, Becky?
I can find one.
You can borrow mine if you want.
You need a white and a black T-shirt for each person
okay.
that is a sinner. They need black and white because they... They do something, okay. and then they go to St. Peter, the Heaven's Gate, and ask St. Peter to get in. He says no, so then they
go
over to Jesus and take off their black
shirt
and put it in the garbage bag, and then Jesus. So let me do.
Have the white one, okay.
Let me do this here. Actually, you can be the person that beats that other person up. And it's going to be, this is going to be Lauren. Okay.
You need the young beauty queen.
Yeah, I need Karina in here. Yeah. Sorry, Karina, you're in.
Sure. No, it's fine.
That's because you're young and beautiful, so you just happened to get the bill.
Why, thank you. Yeah. So this week right now, is that on Moldova or Russia?
We're on Moldova.
Moldova?
Yeah.
Okay.
You can do that in Moldova too. I mean, in Russia too. Russia,
there's gonna be less of us, right?
Yeah. Russia, I'm just gonna tell you what you're doing. You don't get to volunteer. I'm just gonna assign everybody, and that's the way it goes. It's called a dictatorship.
Yeah. We do well with that, Larry.
That's right.
Just tell us where to go and what to do, and we'll do it.
Okay. We get potty breaks.
That's fine. Okay, so.
Yeah. I have to go, Larry.
Okay. Karina, I hope you do well on your exam.
Yeah.
Hey, y'all, we're back. We've been good.
Somehow I don't think so. That is, yeah. Okay, I won't say anything.
I'm paying attention.
Okay. I think we only have one more thing that we actually have to go over, but there's still going to be some more stuff. Okay, so this is water balloon volleyball, which is different than launching water balloons. This one is, you have cleats on either side of the volleyball net, and you throw the water balloon over, and the other side has to catch it. I have a video of it if you want to see it. I don't care. As far as it's really pretty cool. That's it there, I believe. So you get the general idea how that goes. Okay. And that's the same thing that they do with the when you do the launcher, they have to catch the balloons with that. And so I'm going to go back here. And did we have that begs a question. Do we have enough sheets? Did we cover that? I don't know if I nailed that down or not.
I don't think we nailed it down, Larry.
I can bring sheets.
Okay. Is that Becky?
A few.
Yeah, we need
a few. Are they flat ones or the fold form?
Flat. We need one for every 10 people. Unless we put.
But we need like 25.
Yeah.
Jesse said you had some on your list, Larry.
I do. I have. It looks like I have 2, 4, 6. That's what I got.
So then
we still need 20 almost.
If we each brought 2 for sure.
Yeah.
Each of us, yeah.
Yeah.
Like twin sheets, king.
Doesn't matter. Actually, if you bring bigger.
Yeah, whatever.
If you bring bigger ones, we need less. Probably need less. It's going to basically be however big your class is needs to be able to get around the sheets and hold on to them.
Oh, okay. So different sizes are okay.
Yeah, they're fine. It's as you saw in that video when you're actually they were thrown.
Yeah.
That's exact. They need to have enough room for the people to get across there so they can catch the balloons when they come in.
Got it.
All right. So, what did we decide on that, or did we? Oops. You each gonna bring two?
We should each bring two.
Okay. So. We have six, and those will actually serve us well for this right here. Mm-hmm. So Jesse, that's covered with you because you're bringing the water balloons. So just bring some more because we need 100 or 200 of these. Actually, if these balloons could be a little bit bigger than the other ones, like regular balloons, that would be better because you saw it's really looks like it would be a lot funner if they were, you know, big ones than if you're gonna get wet. So let's see. So we'll put Jesse on the balloons. So we need 3 referees for each court, and maybe we'll just use the same people. We have 2 courts, so we need total 6 people. All right, let me just go back to the list here.
I can be in the water balloon.
Okay, Jeff's in there. Larry's in here. David. Jesse. Cindy, Lisa, okay, the bracelets are taken care of, right?
Yes.
They're all done.
They're all in parts.
Okay, great. The Jesus movie, that's a David thing. We have the person to call and give repentance. Sports, obstacle course. We're just going to make that one up as we go.
I like it. Fun.
Okay. Then we're down to... this is just spoons. We need spoons, eggs... And we can get eggs there or cotton. So we really don't need anything other than people assigned to that. And I'll assign the people. They'll like it or not, you're going to get it. And we already did giant volleyball. So that's what I have. And that's the way it'll be. I'll just assign the rest of them because I'm starting to really wear out. And I'll send this out to you guys, whatever I assign. And if you have anything that you really disagree with, you can let me know. Okay.
What about the giant volleyball? Do you already have it, Larry?
Yep.
You have it.
We actually did.
Yeah, we're going to bring some more, Cindy.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
I think we got everything that we need. The other thing.
How many does each camp need, Larry? Because I've got 2 other teams that I have to tell this same stuff to.
I would say
this week.
Yeah. I would say that each camp would need at least 2 to 3 because you always break them. I mean, they always pop unless you get the real heavy duty one. But I looked at those. There's
you went too fast, Jesse.
They're
okay. Good. So I'll tell them they should have at least 2 of them.
Yeah.
Right. Maybe 3.
Yeah.
Okay. Because Romania and Armenia. Still need to have this same training session. So.
Yeah. The day.
Great.
Let's see, just the day that we come in, is there anything that we do with the kids other than from registration? Yes. There is, Jesse. Your question, good question. If you look at the Moldova schedule, we do English. We're supposed to do an introductory English lesson here, okay, which is the 14th, between 2 and 3 o'clock. and it's just these people. So I'm not sure what we're going to do, but we're going to do something because the kids will already be broken down.
Like a group thing?
Yeah, we can do a group thing or we can do it, break it down into smaller groups.
I think it'd be great to do a group thing and then wait and start our groups when everybody else gets there the next day.
Yeah.
Cindy, how far is the camp from the airport?
Let's see. I think they said it's about an hour. Is that right, Larry? Maybe a little bit more.
Yeah. He actually wrote back to me and told me how far it was. I can check here.
Maybe 80 kilometers or something like that. So that's a little more than an hour.
He says, what did he say here?
It's all right.
Questionnaire. These are the people from our, we met this morning. Let's see. He didn't say how far it was.
We're killing gnats.
I think maybe Vitaly said that Batici is about maybe hour to hour and a half, if I'm not mistaken, from Kishinev.
Okay.
By bus.
So right in, yeah. it's not more than that, you guys.
Oh, here it is. Yeah. Time to the camp from airport, 1 hour and 30 minutes.
Oh, good. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Which direction is it, Cindy, from the camp?
Let's see. I have the map right behind me on the wall here.
All right. I think we've beaten these horses deadly. So whatever I end up finding out, as I go through and look at these more closely, I'll make the assignments as I need to, and communicate with you guys via the text, the group text, and then we can go back and forth on that. If you're not comfortable with that, we can just do email. Let's see here. I'm getting tired of doing assignments.
I think it's north of Kishinev.
Okay. Thanks, Cindy.
Okay, I think that's all I have for tonight, unless anybody has anything else.
Jesse has a question in the box there.
For that?
Yes, Jesse, that we will be with the kids all week long.
But they come every day, is he saying that? They come every day?
No, this is a different camp. It's at a campground. I'll show you what it looks like.
Larry, did you happen to get Jessie's flight schedule from Nadia?
No, she said she was going to.
Okay.
Jessie,
we should have that for you by tomorrow, okay?
Yeah. Nadia was, she was working on it, and I don't know what happened with it.
Yeah, she got delayed like several days with it, but she's still trying to get you the best price from Alaska, and I think she'll do a good job. Hopefully, yeah, hope and pray.
I think a good job like that. No, he's not here. There he is.
From Seattle. Sorry. Yeah. So you have to take a flight from where you are in Alaska to get to Seattle first?
Yeah. Here's actually the camp here, Jesse. I guess that's the lake that they got.
Is that Russia or Moldova?
This is Moldova.
Oh.
I think that's
beautiful there.
Yeah, see, they do have a lake, and looks like they may have a ropes course.
Is it fun? Mm.
Yeah. Yeah, it looks like they have a ropes course. All right, any other questions?
Good job, Larry. Thank you.
Thank you, Larry.
You're welcome.
Sorry, it was unexcited, not exciting.
No, I thought it was exciting.
You can see yourself already there, right?
Thanks. Yeah, we can.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Wow, that was a lot of time that you took for us, Larry. Thank you.
Do you want to make another meeting in 2 weeks? Schedule another meeting. That's a question.
Yeah. Does anybody feel like we need another one? We're going to meet separately and make sure we have all the supplies under control.
Do you think
we need one, Larry?
Actually, I think it would be good to do one more on a follow-up and just see if there's any questions. The closer you get to reality, the more questions that you actually have.
That's true.
What about the 28th?
Today is the 14th.
14th, so that would be 2 weeks from today.
Yeah, that sounds right to me.
Is a Sunday night good for everybody?
But,
yep. Yes.
Yeah, it works good for me too.
Okay, let me get this.
Okay, we'll put it down to the 28th.
28th. Talk to you all.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Talk same time, 7 o'clock, standard.
Yep, 7 o'clock. All right, we'll see ya.
All right, thank you, everybody.
Bye, you guys.
Bye.
Thank you.
Yep.